Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we're gonna make this 3D logo, like you see on the screen, dissipate with particles using only four nodes, including the input and output. It's very, very simple. With that said, we'll start an edit page. Go to media pool, right click, new fusion composition. You can name it if you'd like, you don't have to. Bring it down to your timeline and shorten it to 4 seconds. You can also do this with text and other things too. And go to Fusion. Now the logo is nothing but a PNG transparent picture of a logo. You can find a converter online. There's a bunch of them free to use if you need to convert your PNG picture to a transparent one. With the media in selected, shift spacebar and type in P image. A P image emitter is what we want. Then shift spacebar and P render. I suggest not to get too large with your logo. We can make it bigger, and I'll show you that at the end up in the edit page. But if you start out too big, you have to use the transform down here and do a bunch of other stuff that makes it a lot more complicating. This is 1920 by 1080, so it gives you an idea the size of the logo I'm using. With the P image emitter selected, go to the inspector under style. Under style, where it says point, change it to bob. And go down to size control. Take the size all the way up. And go to controls. At the top says random seed. Take that up somewhere close to 200. The lifespan, that's how long you want the particles to last throughout the duration. We want it to go to basically the end of the timeline, which we have 119 frames. So we'll make it right close to that. ...118 should be good. Go down here to velocity. I'm going to take the velocity to around 157 and the velocity variance to 102. Maybe go up a little bit more with the velocity. As you see right now, everything's moving to the right. We want this to just, when it diminishes, to just kind of come maybe towards us a little bit and just everywhere, not just one direction. You can do that with these controls. You can make it go any direction you want. We're going to take the angle Z. and make that minus 90. And we'll go up to edit page and see how it looks. Now these particles take a very long time to render out, so I will be pausing this in between or speeding it up. Okay, the cache is rendered, we'll give it a play. I'm actually happy with that. Now, if you want to change the size of this, you're going to want to add a couple seconds before it, anyways. That way, it has a moment to play before it does its thing. I don't know what to size this. Select them both. Right click. New fusion or new compound clip. Now you'll have to force render it. Right click on it. And go up here to render cache color output. Now it'll render the cache. Again, I will fast forward through this. Okay, once again, the cache is rendered. Give it a play, make sure it works. Now, if you want to resize it, just click on it. Open the inspector, and you can make it whatever size you like. You can move it around. We'll render the cache again, and we'll give it one more play. Just double click on it, go back to record size. Well, there you go. Thanks for watching. See you on the next one.